Local community is seeking solutions after a string of violent crime. Today, Monroe police meeting with the founder of Stop the Killing Crusade. So far this year, police say 5 people have lost their lives to violence in the town. That's more than double than what the city saw in all of 2020. WCNC Charlotte's Ashley Daly joining us live from Monroe with the details on their plan of action. Ashley.
Yeah, Fred, that meeting is just wrapping up here, and it was actually inside where the chief of police said that 6 people have actually lost their lives this year. He says 2 of those 6 are still unsolved, meaning 2 killers are still out there. And he said today he knows that somebody saw something and knows something in both, but says still nobody has come forward.
Monroe, North Carolina is a city just outside Charlotte with a population of less than 40,000 people. But this year, the small city has a big problem.
No mother, no father, no brother, and no sister should have to experience what we're facing here today.
Monroe police say 6 people have been killed this year, totaling more than double what they saw for all of 2020. Among them, 13-year-old Loyalty Allah, shot and killed this July in a drive-by shooting. Police say Allah was sitting at a picnic table with other children when the shots were fired. Then this month, 25-year-old Daisha Franklin showed up at a Union County hospital with a gunshot wound and later died.
That was it. She wanted to raise her kids. She wanted to, you know, do something with herself. Just cut her short before she got a chance.
And then on August 1st, police say they found a 24-year-old shot to death in front of a home on Southwest Street. Police say a fight broke out at a party, leading to multiple shots fired. But they say no one has come forward and his killer remains on the loose.
Folks are seeing these things happen. Folks are knowing that these things are happening in their front yards, in their backyards, and we're not getting the cooperation to bring justice to these victims that we need to.
So today, Reverend Barnett, the founder of Stop the Killing Crusade, joining in on the effort, hoping to reach the community's youth. They say in all but one homicide, all of those involved were under 26 years old.
We use the words that Reverend Jesse Jackson said, nobody can save us from us but us. You know, if we're going to talk about Black Lives Matter, if we talk about racism, if the youth may be committing it, but you got to have the adults involved too. Somebody got to sit at the dinner table and start talking about this. We need to stop the killing.
By joining together, the city, police, and activists hoping to reach the heart of the community so more have the heart to come forward.
And much of the conversation here this evening was, how does this community reach its youth? The police department says they do have programs specifically geared toward teens, but say that teens don't show up. So today, community members actually volunteered saying, hey, I'll go into the high school, meet these teens where they are. The chief of police said that he's up for that idea and says they had programs like that in the past, but COVID had prevented them last year. Live in Monroe, Ashley Daly, WCNC Charlotte.
Ashley, thank you.